is to take people from the truth. You understand the question?
That's different. For example, Ikhwan Muslimin, the ulama mentioned our time, they are one of the worst sects in our time. Because Ikhwan Muslimin, their main target is to cause corruption in Muslim countries for the sake of their leadership. You know, they don't mind causing corruption. They don't mind to unite with Iran or Rafida just for the sake of destroying Muslim countries. That's why now there's a war against Khalij. Why? Because the leaders of the Khalij, they're going after Ikhwans. And Ikhwanis, they are very secretive. Ikhwanis are very, very secretive. Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i said, Ikhwani will come to Yemen and he will say, Hayya ala khayru al-amal. Just to fit in with the Rafida. They're like al-Harba. You know, they change the colors. You know what I'm saying?
Chameleon,
yeah. So they are one of the worst ones. Sururiyun as well. Sururiyun, if in the Salafis, but in reality, they are a mix-up with Ikhwanis. And we have to learn about sects and groups, because you cannot deny there's many groups and sects within Islam. And what we observe in our time, the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam has informed us about it. We cannot deny it. Don't close your eyes and say we're all Muslims. Mashallah, we didn't know that. Yes, we are all Muslims, but are everyone following the truth? Some people following their desires, you know? But alhamdulillah, Islam is being preserved, that we have Quran, the Sunnah, and the books of the Salaf. Alhamdulillah. So Ikhwan, that's what they call Ikhwan al-Muflisun. Sayyid Qutb make ta'an of the Umayyah. He said they were kuffar of Abu Sufyan and Mu'awiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. May Allah please them all. Alhamdulillah, and we have. Alhamdulillah, you see me, I give da'wah to non-Muslims, but also I clarify the truth to the Muslims. You like it or not? Whatever you're going to say about me, alhamdulillah, people lie, slander. Alhamdulillah, that's why we are here. We are upon the clarity, alhamdulillah. That's what we do. And one of the heads of the Ikhwan al-Muslimin died, Yusuf al-Qardawi, has passed away. You know, Yusuf al-Qardawi, when the Pope died, he said, this Pope, may Allah have mercy upon him, we made dua for him. And he said he was a great man. A man that was calling people to worship Jesus. He was a great man, to Yusuf al-Qardawi. Imagine Shaykh bin Baz said that, they were calling him a kafir. Yeah, he said that, it's in a video in Jazeera channel. You can go back to the original meeting or lecture or interview. He said, before we start this show, let us give a ta'ziyah to our Christian brothers. You know, and he goes on to praise the taghut. Subhanallah, man that, and he said he was mukhlis in his da'wah. Mukhlis in his da'wah, what is he calling to? Calling people to worship Jesus. Shirk billah. That's Yusuf al-Qardawi for you. You know? They're going to say, well, Shamsi said Yusuf is going to go to Jahannam. And he said that, by the way. But look how they, you know, Hizbiyun, they're known for that. They will lie. Shamsi, you know, Jahannam in Jannah is in the hand of Allah. Clarifying his misguidance, he was full of misguidance. You see? He called for the NATO to intervene into Libya. What happened in Libya? Destruction. But everyone speaks about Sheikh Rabi' when he gave fatwa, but no one speaks about Yusuf al-Qardawi. You see, subhanAllah. And the worst one, when he said to French Muslim sisters, when you go to, if you want to go to do Riyada, you know, PE, he said, no problem, take off your headscarf. So you sell your deen for PE? May Allah protect us. You know? So he was ahead of misguidance, no doubt about that. You know, alhamdulillah. That man like him, he who spread misguidance upon the Ummah of Muhammad SAW, or within the Ummah of Muhammad SAW. So Ikhwan al-Muflisin, they change. They become Salafi. Now, you know, in Khalij, after them. And you see, those who used to be Ikhwani, now he's Salafi. He said, I'm Salafi. Yeah.
Final question.
Sururiyun is what? Sururiyun are the followers of Muhammad bin Zain al-Abidin. Sururi. You know? His Aqidah, he will tell you a book of Salaf, this, all of that, but Ikhwani Manhaj.
Yeah. Final question. You know, as for criticizing and is it jarh wa ta'dil? I don't know.
Jarh wa ta'dil. Yeah.
Is that a particular field or faculty that people study? And who is it, the one now who actually is able to do that particular study or give that particular?
Jarh wa ta'dil is part of Islam, no doubt about that. Sheikh Fawzan said doesn't exist anymore, and Sheikh Fawzan is wrong. Sheikh Ahmed al-Najmi said it still exists. Sheikh Uthaymeen said it still exists. Sheikh Al-Muhsin Abbad still exists. And we don't blind follow Sheikh Fawzan. Sheikh Fawzan said, khalas, no. Sheikh Fawzan is a big scholar, it's our scholar. But we don't blind follow him. Sheikh Uthaymeen said, even when you go by Even if you want to marry your daughter, you would do shahu ta'dil. You ask about the person. So if someone criticizes him and praise him, you start analyzing. Okay, why I criticize him? Why I praise him? Jarah wa ta'dil. You see? So in your normal life, you do implement it. When it comes to protecting the deen, it doesn't exist. In our time, it's worse than before. How does it not exist? You know, Sheikh Fawzan is wrong. No opinion is wrong. No doubt about that. Abu ulama refute his claim. You know? So the Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, there are specific people for that. The time of the Salaf, there were few of them. Imam ibn Kathir said, this field, not everyone gets involved in it. You know, our time, Sheikh Rabi', Sheikh Ahmed Najmi died, Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh Ubaid, and other scholars, alhamdulillah. You know, but not everyone. And that does not decrease the status of the other scholars. Some scholars are involved in this field. They know individuals very well, they know sects very well. You know, but in our time, akhi, young brothers and sisters, they're very emotional. They say, why are you refuting so-and-so? What do you mean, why? To protect the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have a little knowledge and you know what he said is wrong, then, alhamdulillah, what I could have done, look, when we made video about Muhammad Hijab, what I could have done, I could have collected Muhammad Hijab's mistakes in Quran. But that's not aqidah. I mean, I've heard him recite, his recitation is good, mashallah. So I'm not going to try to jump on it and say, look, he made a mistake here. Even once I was speaking to him, nasab al-fa'il. Nasab al-fa'il, you become a fa'ul bih. It's a great mistake. I didn't mock him. He said, Allahu wa rasulahu. It's Allahu wa rasuluhu. I just said, look at you. How can you be here? Because it happens, sleep with the tongue. But you bandits who are sitting in their homes, and you know, before they make videos, they have to do what? They have to revise first, you know? But when I'm in speaker's corner, I don't have to revise. Straight from the top of my head. You know, straight away, someone speaking to you, imagine hours as well. I have a normal human being brain, you know. So I got tired, I mixed up between the ayat. I mean, even our brother made video defending me. May Allah reward him for that. You know, his name is from America.
Sajid Lipman.
No, not him. He's Lebanese or something. One brother, I forgot his name, he's Lebanese, Arab. He made video defending me, I guess he's Lebanese, but he had to drop a low blow. Yeah, he said, yeah, about the verse, because sometimes what I do, you know, sometimes what we do, is ma'aruf, for example, if I said to you, look, for example, I want to mention that Allah rafa Isa. So I said, look, wama salabu wama qatalu, bar rafa Allah ilayh. That's not, I'm missing many ayat here, but I was just going to bring the shahid from the ayah, you know, and it's ma'aruf, even scholars mentioned that, so, but I didn't say shahid, I straight away mentioned the verse, they said, you know the verse, I know the verse, Surah An-Nisa. وَقَوْلِهِمْ قَتَلْنَا. I don't want to mention myself like, you know, I know the verse very well, alhamdulillah. Even وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ. I said وَلَا لِمُؤْمِنَةٍ. I know وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ. Like, how can you, that shows you, actually, when I watched the video, that was pathetic. You understand? So that's no جَعُوا تَعْدِيلِ. You're not doing جَعُوا تَعْدِيلِ here. You know, that's no جَعُوا. This is you just character assassination. جَعُوا تَعْدِيلِ, when you look at the person, you know, he's making a mistake in aqidah. Okay, now they do intentionally or unintentionally. Because maybe it's with the tongue. Maybe he mixed up, you understand? That's why you have to be honest. Now when I made video about Ali Da'wah, and he said it was unintentional, I didn't make video after that. I said, no, you mentioned it three times and repeated four times, it was intentional. He says, not intentional, khalas, I take it. But when they lied against our Sheikh Abu Iyad, what they did, they were insisting upon lying against him. Even though it was clear, he didn't say it. They took it out of context. But me, alhamdulillah, because I'm doing it for Allah's sake. If the brother now comes and said, look, Shamsi, what I said, I didn't mean it. I said, ah, khalas. You didn't mean it, khalas. I'm not going to make a video. No, prove you meant it because you repeated it three times. Even paper boy said it to you and you still not corrected him. That shows you what? You know, mukhlis. The person said, I did not mean it. And he clearly, but you go on after him. So you can see our refutation, alhamdulillah. Because why? We follow the way of our scholars, alhamdulillah. That when you enter this field, you have to be sincere. And remember, he's a Muslim brother. The end of the day, he's a Muslim. He's no kafir. And the asl of the Muslim blood and the Muslim's honor is sacred. You know, Ibn Daqiq al-Eid, he said, there's two tough people are on the edge of the hellfire. There's two tough people are standing on the edge of the hellfire. Who are they? Guess. Ulama of what? Not the ulama. Ulama of jahu ta'dil and the qudat.
Yeah. Second, sorry.
Qudat, judges.
Judges.
Because judge can give a ruling. He said, yeah. This person is, you know, if he's done it intentionally, then subhanallah, because accusing a Muslim of to do zina and there's no clear proof, you are on the edge. Subhanallah, Ibn Daqiq al-Eidi said, remember this, there's two types of people who are on the edge, standing on the edge of Jahannam. Wal-Iyadu Billah. Al-Qudatu wa ulama al-Jarh wa al-Ta'dil. Because the ass of a Muslim, his honor is sacred. You cannot lie against your brother. Backbite him. You know your brother is tall and he doesn't like to be called tall. And you say he's tall. Don't justify and say, yeah, he knows he's tall. No, if he doesn't like it, don't say it. It's, instead of justify, say, astaghfirullah. You know? Except the ulama say, if he's known by that. Like we have a brother called Uwais Tawil. He's known to be Uwais Tawil. That's he's known for it. You understand? Because it's haram. Let alone slandering a Muslim brother. If you say something about him, it's true, but he doesn't like it, that's backbiting. It's haram. It's a major sin. Let alone slandering him. Wal-iyadu billah. You know? We don't even have enough good deeds, let alone give my good deeds to people. I don't have enough to save myself. I'm going to give you my good deeds. You know, so Zu'ima al-Ju'tadi is not for anyone. Few of them now. And when they speak with justice, alhamdulillah. But they're not infallible. But Imam al-Dhahabi said, yes, they're not infallible, but it is rare when they fall into mistakes. That's Imam al-Dhahabi mentioned, I think one of his books, I can't remember. Understand? You know, so as for claiming that you defend the Quran, and you're waiting for people to make mistakes, tip of the tongue, mixing between the ayat. I mean, like the brother, this Lebanese brother, who said he made a mistake as well in a video in his comfort zone. He said about the verse, ما منعك أن تسجد لما خلقت. He said, لمن, that's incorrect, is لما. خلقت. خلقت means he attributed the fi'l to shaitan. It's خلقت. Afterwards, in the comment section, he corrected it, yeah? But he did correct Lima. He's not Liman, Lima. I'm not going to make a video. The brother, may Allah reward him, he defended me. What's his name? I want to mention. See, sometimes you know, in my head, may Allah forgive me. He's Lebanese, man, from America. Either Lebanese or Palestinian, yeah? Abu Majdi.
Yeah, something like this.
Abu Majdi or something. Anyway, the shahid is, may Allah reward him, but that low blow, brother. I mean, you know, speaker's corner. Brother's come here. I've been here 15 years. Sometimes you're. While you're speaking, someone's interrupting you, you know? And remember, mistake is a mistake. I'm not telling you it's not a mistake. It was a mistake. But was it intentional mistake?